Welcome back, friends. Now we will talk about the remaining portions. So I wanted to find the load in member AD. So how can I find this? This BD acting in the downward direction, and it will be upward because I'm gonna draw a free body diagram at point D. So this is point D. The two is acting in the downward direction. There is something acting in this down direction, and then DE is acting in this direction. And then I can also find the slope of this. This will be 16, and horizontal component, this will be 6, and this will become 17. I'll check it also. So 16 square plus 6 square and square root answer, which comes out to be approximately 17. So BD value we figured out, BD is -1.98, and this is 2, and I wanted to find the rest of the two values. So first of all, again, sigma f of x equal to 0. I'm gonna write the equation. This is AD, which is acting in the upward direction, so this is positive, and then the slope of this one is 6 over 17. This will be plus DB and then minus 2. That will be my equation. So AD 0.6 over 17, DB value is negative 1.98 minus 2 equal to 0. And AD value comes out to be, this is approximately 2, so 3.98 positive, and divide, multiply by 17, divided by 6. So 3.98 multiply by 17 divided by 6. That's gonna give me 11.27 AD value. And this value is positive, so this is a tensile force. I'm gonna write AD equal to 11.27. And now I wanted to find the ED value. So I'm gonna say, what are the horizontal forces? ED negative AB, this is 16 over 17 and equal to 0. So this is AB is 11.27, 16 over 17 equal to 0 minus ED, and ED value comes out to be, this value becomes positive, goes on the other side of the equality, 27, 16 over 17. So 11 multiplied by 16 divided by 17, which comes out to be 10.6 ED value, which is negative. So negative means this is a tensile force. So ED, I'm going to write it here, which comes out to be 10.6. This is the value we got. And because this is a negative, so this is a compressive force. This is compressive. You can also write ED equal to 10.6 compressive. So we figured out the ED value. Now we're gonna try and find the rest of the values. So we're gonna draw a free body diagram about point, I can say E. So point E, if this is moving in the downward direction, this is away, this is in this direction F, this is A, EA, and then ED. ED, we know the value of ED, which is 10.6 negative. And if I draw the vertical forces, this is 2, so I can say AE, this is at an angle of, this is 8, this is 6, and this is 10. Is there anything else we need to draw in this? No. So AE value multiply by 6 over 10 minus 2, sorry. AE equal to 0.8 times 0.6 equal to 2. AE equal to 2 divided by 0.6. 2 divided by 0.6 comes out to be 3.3. AE comes out to be 3.3 positive. Again, it's a, so it means if it is a positive, it is a tensile force. AE equal to 2.3.3. 3.3, that's what we figured out. Now, I wanted to find the value of, EF. So EF can be figured out by taking the horizontal component, if I'm not mistaken. EF negative, and then I have less space here. So EF minus, or this is positive, ED, but minus 8 over 10 AE equal to 0, negative EF plus ED minus 0.8 AE equal to 0. AE value is, AE we figured out is 3.3.8 times 3. This I'll erase the 0. So 3.3 equal to 0. And do I know the value of ED? ED value, ED is negative 10.6. Negative 10.6 minus EF. E negative EF comes out to be, this is also negative, and this is 0.8 times 3.3 plus, I'm going to add because both are negative values, 13.24, and then this goes on this other side, becomes positive, but EF, because this is negative, so negative 13.24. So EF comes out to be 13.24 then compressive. So we figured out this value. So now we are left with finding one value. So that is AF. So I can easily find that value also if I draw the free body diagram about point F. So if we draw a free body diagram about point F, we're gonna say AF is acting in the upward direction, then there is this reaction force, and then there is this force in this direction. Notice I'm showing this direction in the right hand side because that's what we assumed when we started solving this question. So I'm going to keep the direction whatever we assumed in the beginning, and I'm going to file the value. So RFX is 16 kips, which is positive, so the direction assumed is correct. So I'm going to keep on using the same direction. Although if this was a negative, I still would have kept the same direction, whatever I've assumed at the first instance. So this is, do I need to draw anything else? No. So this is, I can say AF. Is there any other force acting at this point? At AF. So AF, this is in this direction at point F. If I draw, no, so this is 16 and this is F, this is FE, and this value comes out to be 13.24 AF, and sigma F of X equal to 0, so AF comes out to be 0. Let's check out our values. Take a couple of seconds to check me the values. So let's see the values. AF 0, that's correct. This value is correct, this value is correct, so all our values are correct. So that's it for the question. Hopefully you were able to understand the method of joints. See you in my next video. Have a good day. Bye.